Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode of the Peepshow. Look at all this wood, man. What a great starter chest. I haven't gotten one of these in a long time, so I figured why not see what's inside? It's been a while. Get some goodies in there. That's not bad. So, it is 1.11 time. Lots of stuff to check out. Lots of stuff to check off the check mark boxes. But I think we should be able to have some fun today. So, some things added into the game are the alpaca or the llama, which has some interesting characteristics. There's also the... Oh, I'm in creative mode right now, aren't I? Here, let's turn that off. Let's go survival mode for the minute. Game mode, zero. So yeah, there's just a lot that's been added to the game. I uploaded a video in my Building with B00 series yesterday, and I said I'm not very excited about it, but I got to admit, once you get in, it is pretty exciting to hunt for that new stuff and find what's out there. Is my auto jump on? I bet you it is. It isn't. Nice. First of all, I'm very happy that I spawned in a plains biome because villages are... Ooh, nope, that's not anything. There's something waiting for us in the village. So I want to find that. I also don't think... Ooh, a desert temple. What a good find right off the bat. I'm not able to run my texture pack. My resource pack? Yeah, it's incompatible right now. There's just a little tag that I have to change. That's no problem. I can do that. But, let's see. Is there a village over this horizon? I'm a little bit surprised. But I guess I'll go hunting. Look for a little bit of a village. Hey, Sand Bunny. Hi. Ooh, look at that dangerous ground. You know what else I'm noticing? The land seems to be generating fairly well. At a decent rate, so that's nice. See, ooh, there's more plains over here. I've got a feeling. No, it's not generating very well. That should be loaded over there. Something to do. You know what? I'm on a brand new computer. I'm on a brand new computer. I got a 1080 graphics card. Amazing processor. Why does the land not load so good in the Minecraft now? This is new. I didn't know that this was a thing. Gravel, grass growing on gravel? Hello? Hello? Why did you grow there? Now it's gone. Okay. So, I just did a little bit of recording without you by accident. I found a village. I just recorded this amazing segment, and then I said, okay, be right back, and I looked over, I was not recording, but look at this guy, the green villager. Ooh, there's a husk over there, a whale. That's cool. That's a new zombie. He's not burning up for some reason. But over here, it looks to me like all of the white, ouch, all the white cloak villagers are cartographers now. There is a librarian. Okay, but the cartographer looks exactly like the librarian. He has a white cloak as well. And, you guys are never getting out of here, are you? Here you go. You're free. Kind of. Are you free? Jeez, what a hole. I'm free now. There we go. Okay. Let's see if I can find this cartographer. Is that him there? There he is. Okay. So yeah, I traded all this stuff with him. He gave me an ocean explorer map, and he gave me a woodland explorer map. Now, I didn't know that there were two types of maps. So the woodland explorer map tells us where this new mansion is, and that's pretty cool. If you look down in the bottom left-hand corner, you can see a little white dot, and I believe that's me. So as I travel in one direction, I'll maybe see if that dot moves closer. You know, if it's moving this way, then I know you kind of get an idea of where you're at. There's also this ocean explorer map. And it shows me where an ocean temple is, which is really, really cool. So I think the lines, the areas with the lines and these squigglies are rivers and bodies of water. B-dubs needed to have a drink. But that's pretty exciting. I like that a lot. So I guess we're off. Now that we got these maps... And what it took was, if you didn't see, 16 emeralds and a compass. So it's really not much to get that from that guy. It doesn't take much. It's definitely not an end game sort of thing to get the map. But traveling wise, maybe it is. So I'm going to head off and see if I can make sense of any of these maps. Okay, so I've been traveling around for a little bit here. Not seeing that dot move very much. But this actually brings up an opportunity. This is a new feature as well that they added, and it's the locate, which is going to be really good for administrators. It's kind of a game spoiler. You wouldn't want to use it yourself. Well, maybe you would. But if you just hit slash locate and then tab, it shows you all the potential things it can locate. The end city, fortress, mansion, mineshaft, monument, stronghold, temple, village. Pretty cool. So if we hit F, unable to locate any fortress feature. What? Oh, not fortress. We didn't want fortress. We wanted mansion. Aha. Mansion is at 4. Look at how far away it is. If I type it again, will it show me another one? No. 472. Negative 8,000. Boy, we would have been traveling forever. So 472, we're about on that right now. And then negative 8,000 this way. Holy cow. That is quite the travel. All right, I'm off to see the wizard. Okay, we're getting much, much closer. And you'll notice... As we get closer, the dot gets bigger. So the larger the dot is, the closer you're getting to your destination, which is very, very cool. That's kind of how I'm seeing the map working. Also, though, in the Extreme Hills biome, you should be able to find the alpacas. I believe they're in mountainous areas, is what it says. So we should come up on some... Pretty soon, I imagine. No? I don't see any. Very interesting. Let's just continue on this way because we're about to see in this roofed forest. Let's get the real deal feel of this thing. We're about to see in this roofed forest. Oh yeah, okay. Oh, and the map's starting to, look at the map start to lighten up too. Yeah, it's starting to reveal everything. Oh, that's so cool. Okay, so we're getting very, very close. Ooh, I can go through this little hole. Is that the mansion right there? I'm looking right at it, man. Oh, that's awesome. You can see it through this little hole in there. Okay, there she is. Wow. All right. Let's take a little flyover and see if I'm just looking for alpacas still. Or llamas. See if we can get a good look at what this thing looks like. Wow. Okay, so there's the entrance. It's not the most glamorous looking build in the world, but it's okay. All right, there's the entrance. Very dark inside. Some torches, though. How crazy is this, guys? This is Minecraft. Sheep spawned on top of it. Very good, very good. Let's kill a couple of these sheep, actually. I'll take you. Thank you. Excuse me. Ooh, brown. These are, like I said, for... Oh, I hear you in there, boy. Yeah. We're going to take these guys on firsthand. Oh, a bunch of obsidian right there? Okay, I'm not going to do this. I'm not going to... Oh, there's a big spawner right there. Spider spawner. Holy cow. Okay. Let's let's do this thing. So there it is. You get the idea of what it looks like. 69 frames a second. What's going on, Minecraft? We probably turn this down, I guess, since we're this far out. Okay, let's go in, though. Let's do it. Do this thing. I'm going to do it cheaty, okay? But I want to be able to get a good look at everything. So, skeletons right off the bat here. Yes. Gotcha. You ain't going to shoot at me, boy. Let's go this way. Oh, man, they made little separate rooms. I mean, what's the purpose of this? Anything under here? Cobblestone? Okay, there's a two-layer cobblestone foundation. I mean, this is pretty cool, man. Not really decorated or anything. There is not many decoration pieces in the game. A farm with lily pads? No way! How genius are these people? An inside farm. Okay. This kind of proves to me the Minecraft developers. This is why we don't get a whole lot of building updates. Because they aren't big into the building stuff very much. Here's like a villager. What? A villager made out of wool. Anything inside of this thing? Ooh. What was that piece that I just broke? What is this? Torch. Torch, B-dubs. What was that? Torch. Boom. Oh man, I just broke something. I don't know what I just broke. Dang it. It might have been something good. Shoot. Oh well. Oh, is that the illager guy? That's him, I think. You can hear him. Oh, is this him? Uh-huh. What's up, boy? Okay, can't trade with him. Let's open this door and see what's in here. Nothing. Uh-huh. Okay, I think I might put on some armor and consider fighting this guy just to see what the whole fight is like. Let's put on this, and put that on the ground. Okay, boom, 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 boom. Game mode zero. Here we go. Hello. He carries an axe. He's dead. What? What? It was three shots with the regular sword. What? Oh, there's multiples. There's lots of them. Hello, there's a tree in here. Hello, creeper. Is that? Ah, he shot him towards me. I'm still good at this game, man. Boom, you're dead. I have one torch. Okay, was this like a farm? What is this aqueduct thing? What is this? That's weird. Makes no sense, but it's there. I'll take it. Aha! I got an axe off of him. There's an anvil here, some lava. Okay, that's cool. Very good. Okay, so we saw what the fight was like with him, right? We get it. That's all right. It's not great, but it's something. It's something. It's something to explore. I'm just wondering, like, what's the really good loot around here? I think there's more stuff that we're missing. There are the Vexes in the game as well. It's up here. Nothing. No, nothing there. Okay. Running through here. Bookshelves. We got a library. I mean, that's tons of bookshelves for decoration stuff, so that's nice. Oh, tons of bookshelves. Okay. That's good to know. I mean, making that many bookshelves would be such a pain, so nice find. What's in here? Nothing. Oh, they're fairly empty, man. A chest. Ooh! Okay, that's a really good chest. Wow. Yeah, that's a really good chest. Okay, that's good to see. Maybe there's more of those that I've missed. Okay. All right. So this guy is definitely different. That guy. All right. We'll take a look at him. Killing him is not going to be easy, I don't think. Let's get all this cleared out. Let's light this place up a little bit. Wow, that's not a very good sword. Okay, let's go back to game mode zero. Oh yeah, there he goes. Yeah. He's dead. What? What? Is a map of the world, though. Look at those little guys, man. Oh, whoa, whoa. Whoa, hey. There's a lot of them. There's like four of them. Oh, can I hit them? Are they hitting me? I don't think they're real. Are they real? What? I hit him? They're not hitting me. I killed him. What? Yeah. Gotcha. Yeah! Wrecked. Okay, that's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. I like it. I like it. All right, so we did that thing. We got that worked out pretty nice. Now, what he dropped, you saw it. He dropped this, the Totem of the Undying. So this has some unique features to it. I believe if you right-click it, no? What do? I thought you right-click it. I know it can save you, but I thought if you right-click it, it gave you an effect. Maybe you gotta put it in this hand? No. But I think it showed them holding it in that hand. I think that's the way you want to do it. But yeah, I think that's the entire mansion. I think there might be another side. Yeah, there is another side to it. But we got kind of the feel for it. That's pretty cool. I'm down, Minecraft. You did an okay thing here. This would be fun for people to explore and stuff. Oh, you know what? We never found the spider thing. I don't think we are done here. Yeah, here's another room with that guy. Uh-huh. Creeper, blow up. Oh, I wanted him to kill him. Dang it. How many times? Oh, that's right, I'm doing the spam clicking. Let's not fight him, though. We already saw what that battle's all about. Anything in here? No, but up here is where it gets really bad. Who is this? Just an infected zombie, I think. Okay. Yes, and dead. All right, a couple of these dudes up here. Oh yeah, there you are. Okay, ooh, whoa. Let's let this fight go on a little longer. Yes, almost dead actually. Okay, he's spawning lots of those guys, so you ideally want to kill him really fast. Got another one of those totem things. So you could potentially run out of here with three of those totems, looks like. Pretty sick. Okay, I like it. I feel like that's a full explore. No, it's not, man! Where's the freaking spiders? The spider. They're behind there. Yeah, they're behind there. Aren't they? Game mode one. Aha! The secret room. I don't know why you'd want to go in here. Is there a secret room over here as well? Oh, there is, with all this obsidian. And a diamond block inside. Okay, 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 okay. That's pretty cool. Okay, so there's some cool little hidden features in there that I think are pretty nice. But we've got more to do. We got to go find that alpaca pronto. I think we found them. I did not know they looked like this. Maybe they're different colors. There's different colored ones. But here they are. The llamas. Oh, there's baby llamas as well. Oh, that's awesome. Okay. Huh? They're making noises. Okay. So you tame it. Just as you do a horse, he turn around looking at me. Hi, are we friends now? Can you feed him sugar? I wonder. But it says also they'll spit at enemies, which I don't know if we'll be able to test. We could try it. Okay, are we good now? We're good now, yeah. Okay, so, cool, man. Check that out. So you can decorate them with different types of wool. So let's make, let's get off him here. And let's make, go game mode 0 and make this. And put some different wool on him. Oops. Yeah, that'll work. Hello, get that off of there, and boom. Yeah, that's awesome. It's like he got sunglasses on. How cool is that? Now, can I drive him? Hello? I'm definitely not controlling him. Oh, okay. So maybe they aren't ridden like that, but let me check this real quick. Okay, inventory slots. So let's do this. It's time to go into the inventory and get the shulker box. Now this, oh, you can recolor them. I did not know you could recolor them. Okay. So that's interesting. That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. I like that. All right. So you can put a bunch of stuff in it. And then you just, it sounds like metal. So I wonder, pickaxe. Yeah. Pick it up. Move it. All your stuff's still in there. Very, very cool. But from what I hear, the benefit of these guys is you can... Let's just take this off. Can we put the shulker box in? Oh, do you have to put a chest on them? Yes. You right-click them with a chest. You right-click them with a chest, and they get a chest on their sides, and then they gain an inventory. So, can I do this to all of them? No, I have to tame it first. But the great thing about these, I thought you could have ridden them. So you could take this and put your shulker box in there, six of them, have a full huge inventory, right? But on top of that, let's grab a lead. I'm not even gonna search for it, let's just get one. And let's grab him. Come on this way, boy. So if we get him and bring him this way, let's say we had all these tamed, right? We had inventory on all of them. This should work. Yeah. The nearby llamas are gonna follow. Now, something that this game has always had a hard time with is following. Like with wheat, you know how I try to bring an animal over with wheat? But I'm just gonna put this to the test and just see. I'm not gonna be super ginger with it. I'm just gonna go. Okay, I've got all these llamas here. I keep saying alpacas, gotta stop that. Okay, and we're just gonna go around here, down here. Don't wanna kill it. Boy, they're following pretty good. They're doing a pretty good job of following. I just wonder how good this would be if you wanted to move just tons and tons of inventory. Okay, I broke the lead. That definitely is still a thing. All right, come on. There are a lot of llamas following there, though. Come on. Come on. Now, they've probably taken damage along the way, so having like a good clear path would probably be smart. Come on. Okay, they stopped coming. Did they see like an area they can't get through, it looks like? Boy, he walks weird. Wow. Okay. All right. That's cool, man. Back and forth. Okay, we lost them all. So, they're all back here, aren't they? Yeah, they're all backed up right here. But, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 right there. And how many didn't make it? 1, 2, 3, 4... four of them. So that's pretty good. I mean, if you have a bunch of them tamed and you just say, I'm going off, I'm taking a ton of blocks, I got a huge build coming, I'm taking a ton of blocks a certain way, you can have almost infinite amount of inventory space. 27 times 6 is what? I don't know. 27 times 6 times however many alpacas or llamas you're willing to have follow you. Pretty cool. But this is a little concerning. Probably the water freaked them out, I imagine. So that is pretty sick. But to make that shulker box, you just put a, I believe it's a crafting or a chest in the middle and two shulker shells on either side, and boom, there you go. The shulker shells are dropped by none other than the shulkers, everybody. Surprise! Okay, but is this how you dye them? Like so? Like that? Huh. Weird how it's letting us do that, though. And it took them. So apparently that's going to be the mechanic, because it takes them. Look. 7, 6. It takes the dye. So that's got to be the mechanic. Just one next to it. So that's pretty cool, though. Now, if I'm not mistaken, though, Observer Block is in the game now. It sure is. Now, this is very, very interesting. Could really make for some really cool redstone contraptions. Let's put just a piston over here. Not TNT. Maybe TNT, yes. Why not? So I believe that's the backside. I think I have it all facing the right way. So I think this just observes any sort of block change. Yeah, it's giving a pulse. Interesting. And is it just a one redstone pulse? It looks like just a one tick. It's not going any further than this. Oh. Redstone hitbox is changed? Two? I thought redstone always took up the whole block. Oh, that's strange. Maybe that's... Okay, so that's giving one pulse. So let's put a repeater on it then. And see what happens. I did not know the hitbox changed like that. I wonder what that would affect. Okay, so you put that anything down, it'll fire. It's a very quick, short pulse, which is really, really cool. Short pulse like that. But you could even do like the farms. I've mentioned that before. That's a cool idea that's very, very simple. But I wonder if you throw like a splash potion in front of it. No, that doesn't do anything. Yeah, but very, very cool. You can also, I believe, the shulker boxes, they get moved. Oh, I like the look of that one. By pistons, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, it just pops it off. So you set that up not a funnel. What's the freaking thing called? Hopper. Funnel, and you could have some item transportation, some massive item transportation, which I think could be really, really, really cool. There's a couple other things that were added, like some curse enchantments and stuff like that, but not going to show those here. Lastly, I figured out what the Totem of the Undying does. Okay, so if you take a fatal blow that should kill you, it will consume the totem, and it will bring you back to life, give you absorb, and regen. So, let's give it a try! Game mode 1. Game mode 0. And this should do the trick. Oh, there we go! Yeah, we should have died from that. We didn't. It took the 1. And we got the regen. Look at that! Wow. Okay, that's really cool. That's a really, really cool feature. To have that in your hand. Oh man, I like that a lot. Okay, you know what? I went in thinking not very cool, not a whole lot of stuff. And honestly, as a builder, I'm probably not gonna do much of this stuff in, you know, my everyday Minecraft stuff, but I think it could be a very cool update and make for some great content for people out there. So I'm excited about it. Hope you are too. Thank you guys so much for watching this episode of The Peep Show. We'll see you all next time.